Do you make it a habit of being dishonest when you give interviews?
When I give interviews, I tell whatever I want to say to help sell records.
With all due respect, I was high and drunk every time I did an interview last year.
And Mr. Thick, I do have to ask you, when you did the interview that we just played from VH1, were you drunk and on Vicodin?
I didn't do a single interview last year without being high on both.
Okay. So the answer to my question is yes.
Yes.
Were you drunk and on Vicodin when you did the Oprah show?
Yes.
Do you consider yourself an honest person?
No. I didn't even use the Marvin Gaye thing until everyone started saying to me, hey, it's reminiscent of the Marvin Gaye song.
In quotes, you'll see a statement where Mr. Thick says, quote, Pharrell and I were in the studio making a couple of records, and then on the third day, I told him I wanted to do something kind of like Marvin Gaye's Got to Give It Up. Did he tell you that?
No, sir.
Okay.
Unfortunately, these questions that you're asking me refer to a portion of our business in the music industry when people come in, sometimes to either co-write or when they need songs. Sometimes they embellish those stories. And so what you're hanging your hat on here is a guy that, you know, wants the world to perceive that, like, you know, that song is primarily, you know, like his he had the impetus of the genesis for it. But that's not the way I work, A. B, again, I'll just highlight this to you. What you're doing is you're taking excerpts from a conversation of an interview where a guy is presenting to the world that these are his songs. So he's going to say, yeah, I got such and such and such and such and such and such. But that's not the case. I'm happy to answer all these questions. But unfortunately, this is the part of it all that just makes it a little confusing for you.